I love it. I love it, man. That connection and that competition is huge. So first up that we got Noah Brannock. We got some highlights from him. Talk a little bit about, you know, Noah, just a little bit about his background when you started working with him.
Yeah, so Noah, he goes to Calvert Hall College High School in Towson, Maryland. Noah, he's a kid who is really, his recruitment is really starting to take off. You know, he's done a visit to Coastal Carolina. He was at University of Maryland last week. He went to Columbia. He's on pace to go to Virginia Tech. And we also have Penn State coming up as well. So he's a kid. He competed in the Elite 11 last year, had a really strong showing. He'll be there again this upcoming year, and I'm looking forward to him having another big performance there as well. So he's definitely one of just a quarterback who can go out there and make every single type of throw. That's going to be demonstrated on his film, you know, and he's a leader, somebody who can go out there regardless of what the atmosphere may be. He's cool, calm, collected at all times, and, you know, he's definitely fun to watch.
Awesome. Well, I'm excited to dive in. He's got some videos uploaded on his profile here. I think the latest highlights are over on YouTube. So let's go check those out. But excited to dive in and see the latest on, you know, a trending quarterback, class of 2023 quarterback. And excited to see, you know, why you're so hyped, what you guys have been working on, and where we can continue to come up from here. So Noah Brannock.
As you can see right there, very first pass is a dime. So this is him showing great pocket presence, you know, climbing up in the pocket, keeping his eyes downfield, evading the defender, you know, stopping right before he crosses the line of scrimmage and delivering a strike, you know, 40 yards down the field. So, you know, that really kind of sums Noah up right there.
Yeah, that's incredible. Yeah, this is the first time, obviously, I've seen this. But, you know, what stands out is the amount of distance that this ball travels, not getting above a certain height. You know, they talk a lot about, you know, that shows the velocity, that shows the spin rate that this football has on it. And just, you know, when I think of watching film, especially at the class of 2023 junior level, it's, you know, how are you showing that you're an outlier, and that that would be turning heads at the college level?
Absolutely. 40 yards on the rope, man. It doesn't get much better than that. And that's in between two defenders, too. So we're talking about ball placement. We're talking about trajectory. Being able to maintain.
I got to be careful here because I could go on and we could break this down forever. And I'm gonna riff off of it because, you know, I just got to know, because I know it's, you know, your focus is in the biomechanics. So real quick, just on this. How much of this is biomechanically sound, and how much is this Noah being just pretty special? Break that down a little bit. And obviously, this is the first play, so we'll try to keep going. But, you know, also we gotta answer the questions that matter, Aaron. Right? And I think that matters for sure. When you see a throw like this,
for sure, man. It's about 50-50 even right there. So this is actually something that we rep. You know, you three-step drop in the pocket, the pressure's coming at you. We have to make an evasive movement, but maintain, you know, what we talk, base and balance, keeping our eyes downfield. You know, being able to get right back to my spot and fire that back hip, you know, to deliver an accurate ball with the right amount of velocity onto it. So as you can see, right before he throws the ball, his shoulders close in the direction that he's going to. He has a stable base. You know, he drives that back hip forward, and that ball travels. And so, you know, Noah's an extremely hard worker. You know, he always shows up. He's ready to put in that work, and it shows on Friday nights, as you can see right here. And then also, I mean, he's just special, man. I've seen him do things that we kind of just laugh because you can't really explain it, and he just walks back and just, like, has the most cool demeanor of all time. So that's also just Noah being Noah.
Yeah, that's 40 yards on a rope. So that – that will get the attention of evaluators, that's for sure. So let's try to get to the second play. You know, we could hang on that one all day. So
here we go again, man. You see him? He took what we call a Brady step, named after obviously Tom Brady. Has the rush coming right in his face, doesn't faze him at all, delivers a dime down the sideline. Nice touch pass. He saw that it was a one-on-one coverage backside. That was a matchup that he felt that they could beat. And there you have it. It's not smooth, easy to do that, man. Smooth. To go past with somebody in your face.
Yeah. Well, I just think of when you ever see players that are smooth, you got to ask, why are they smooth? And it's because they make the difficult stuff look easy. And I think that that's kind of what you're seeing here in terms of, you know, the throw on time, the touch on it. You know, really look at the hit that he does take. You know, that's a pretty big hit. Mm-hmm. He knows what he's doing. You know, that's not the first time he's made that throw. That throw like that doesn't happen by chance. So credit to you, Noah, for putting in the work.
Definitely. Here we go. Off platform to the right. Close shoulder, square hips, and another strike right in the corner. Another corner route right there over top of the defender.
And how I'm going to do this, Aaron, just because I want you know what's notable, what's not. So I'm going to let the highlights go through. And when you have points that you want to make and call out, let me know. And I'll
Sure. We can go ahead and play that one back. So as you can see, he's climbing up in the pocket again, rushes in his face, doesn't let it phase him. So here's one of the key things that we want to see with quarterbacks, right? When you have pressure in your face, do you take your eyes from downfield and focus on the rush, or do you keep your eyes downfield and stay poised? And this is what he does right here. And again, delivers a strike. Notice how he pulls the receiver away from the two defenders. Three defenders.
Hits
him in stride. Touchdown.
Look at this throw.
That's Noah being Noah, man.
Let me see, what's that? Was it the 45?
Yeah.
45 down to the 20?
35, special, man.
40 yards. It's wild.
And delivers a strike.
No, you'd have an offer from me, man. You know, I've seen what I need to see at this point. So I can't give those out anymore, but.
Yeah, man. Nah, just like I said, man, he's definitely somebody that we're really excited about that, you know, this is his, because of COVID, he didn't really have a chance to have a year last year, but he didn't let that stop him. He was training literally 5 times a week. There goes another dime right over top of the defender. Watch this play right here. Watch this. Nah, this next one. This one right here. Very Johnny Manziel-esque. Let's see. Look, keeps his eyes downfield and delivers a strike.
Oh, my.
Touchdown.
That's wild, man. Let's go, Noah.
Very Johnny Manziel-esque.
We got to get this viral. Leland, this is like a layup for LeBron. These clips are like a layup for LeBron. We got to, you know, no, we got to get these out here. This is definitely giving me flashbacks to the Alabama game, Texas A&M, watching Johnny run around in the red zone.
This right here, you can't coach. Like this, there's no drill for this. There's no situation. This is just, you know, a kid operating in his most supreme confidence, you know, that believes that no matter what, he can make a play. And I mean, clearly he can. You know, look at how he's scrambling, but he's keeping his eyes downfield the entire time. So he's moving with a purpose. He's not just running, trying to, you know, for the sake of running. He's trying to create space. His receiver's doing an excellent job of working with him to create a lane for him to throw the ball to. And then he sees it. You know, to be able to turn around and jump and spin and heave this ball 25 yards on a rope, like that's, you just, some things you just really can't explain. Yeah, exactly. You know, like, look at where the receiver's at and look where he throws it. Crazy. And it was a tight spot.
Well, and it says something about the wide receiver to even think that this play is not dead, right? I think that that says something in itself. I think this is the type of play that would never, ever make any coach feel comfortable, but they would always put up with it just because of the you know, the success of it. So keep throwing these so they don't allow you anymore, Noah, and do your thing.
Good job working through his progressions right there. You can just see his head movement as he's trying to move defenders. Delivers another strike. Rolling out to the right. Throws a dime. Who's at 30 yards?
Yeah. Only got 9 views right now. 9 views.
It, It just went up, so we definitely gotta promote
that. We gotta crank it up. Absolutely, 100%. Absolutely. Well, I know we're getting to the 10-minute mark on Noah, and we're trying to get through, you know, seven of the athletes tonight. But before we move on, give me kind of your final thoughts of Noah, or, you know, what will allow him to keep ascending, just continue to do his thing. What kind of last little shout outs or pieces of advice would you have as we move on to the next athlete?
Yeah, I mean, Noah, he's a program changer. You know, the school that he's at, Calvert Hall, they're not historically known for winning. They're 7-2 right now. You know, they're the number two seed in the MIAA. They're going to the playoffs. Their first playoff game is this Friday night versus Mount St. Joe, I believe. And he makes people around him better. He makes people around him believe that they have a chance, even when, you know, the outside naysayers might say otherwise. And so, you know, whatever school is fortunate enough to get him, you know, to take that chance on him and offer him a scholarship that he commits to, from day one, you're going to get somebody that's a leader, that's going to come in there, fire guys up, and is going to make plays. You know, no moment is ever too big for him. He just rises to the occasion. So, you know, definitely excited to see just his continued development and how it all plays out for him.
Hey, that's high praise. That's high praise. That's, you know, exciting stuff. So, Noah, we're going to stay tuned, and best of luck the rest of the season. Next up,